Today, we're going to take a look at the tech scene in Germany and see how the 42 model fits into it. We will talk to some of our students, staff members, to get a better understanding of whether it still makes sense to learn how to code at 42. Getting into tech today can be a bit confusing. We hear so much about tech layoffs, AI taking over, different languages that are becoming redundant, different skills that are becoming redundant, and yet so many people still want to learn how to code and want to be part of building this reality, this new AI-driven reality.
I think I want to be someone that understands the program that is being written in order to enable the AI to write me an even better project.
I love the fact that I type something and the computer understands and gives me something else. It feels a little bit magical.
A lot of hiring managers, when they talk to our students, they are under an impression that they are overqualified. Why? Because they know how to build everything in C. Our curriculum focuses on C, not without a reason. It is the mother of all languages, and thus, if you know how to build a complicated program in C, you know how to build it in any other language very easily.
What allows you to learn through learning C is that you actually understand the way that memory is manipulated. It helps very much to actually build performant and production-ready applications.
The 42 curriculum is extensive and yet accessible. Because of the fact that we use peer-to-peer and a gamified learning methodology, anyone without any prior experience can jump into learning at 42 as long as they have a lot of drive, motivation, and ability to collaborate.
The most surprising thing about 42 was probably that you can learn things on your own. And you can stay intrinsically motivated over a long period of time. You gain a lot of trust in yourself.
What makes us unique is the fact that we don't use a typical teacher-student model with scheduled timetables. Students who study with us need to be teachers as well as students. They need to have the ability to explain their code to others very clearly. They need to know how to receive feedback and how to give it.
What's really surprising is how people are willing to help you. They will stop doing whatever they're doing and they will go try to find the answers that you can find.
This is the essence of peer-to-peer methodology. There are still exams and there are ways to check your progress along the projects, but you learn in a very systematically community-driven system.
A key point is learning to collaborate and not to be competitive. I find that traditional education very much fosters competitiveness, and in my opinion, we need collaboration to solve any kind of problem.
This all might sound very fluffy, but hiring managers for tech companies still name collaboration as the number one most important skill they look for in their future employees. That's why 42 graduates are extremely employable.
42 is a school based on projects. You learn how to search for the answer and you get also answers from your peers that already do the project or are doing the project or have an opinion about it.
You learn how to learn anything, and you probably will only discover it once you start studying with us.
It's really rewarding when you actually grasp the concept, because it's you got there by yourself with some help of your peers probably, but you didn't have someone chewing the answer and give it out to you.
Tech industry is still struggling massively with inclusivity and diversity of coders. What we managed to achieve at 42 Berlin is a close to 40% to 60% gender split. I don't need to explain to you why diversity and inclusivity in tech matters. We build better products, we collaborate better, there are more ideas in the room. Tech needs to be inclusive.
So you have different kind of challenges that don't only apply to just coding and do what you want to do. You have to align, you have to coordinate.
You can get stuck alone. You can also get stuck together, but if you have a third person, then you always have some kind of creative input.
The biggest game changer around 42 is that it is completely free. There are no special requirements, no special conditions. If you get in, if you pass the PCN, you study with us for free. And the PCN is obviously free as well. So here we come with extremely talented students who come from diverse backgrounds and not only know how to code extremely well, but also know how to learn anything. Does that work for the tech of today? Yes, and here's why. There are a lot of people trying to predict what is the tech industry going to look like in the next few years? What are we going to need? What are the skills that are the most important ones? In all reports, the same thing seems to be popping up. We will need more advanced tech talent. Except for now, the talent and the skills they have will need to be slightly different. Diverse backgrounds matter.
Before 42 Berlin, I was working for almost 5 years as a product manager. So as a product manager, I was always working with a lot of engineers, software engineers together. And I was always a bit mesmerized and kind of like surprised and excited about all the work they were doing and kind of turning something that we were talking about into reality.
Before 42, I was preparing to start a veterinary school in Germany. Coming from Brazil and because of COVID, I thought I would like to have a career that allows me to work in a computer. So I chose coding.
Someone having a background in design or in gastronomy, someone having background in biology is going to be extremely important. The fact that you had a life before joining tech will make you so much more hireable and important for the industry. Another part of it is the human skills, the soft skills. All of the sudden, they will matter so much more than before. In the world driven by AI, your ability to talk to other people, connect with them, and build successful teams will be crucial.
I don't feel threatened by AI. Specifically, I think humans are still very necessary in terms of coming up with a solution. I feel more threatened by climate change than AI, to be honest. 42 teaches us to adapt to every small or big change, and also to work from project to project, and not out of fear, but out of purpose, let's say.
As of spring 2025, in Germany, there are 770,000 open roles in IT. 16,000 of those are in Berlin alone. Berlin has over 178,000 developers working in the city. And that number keeps on increasing. Despite the turbulence of the last few years, we will see a growing demand for software engineering roles. And let's not forget that being a trade software engineer opens doors to so many different roles in tech. So does the 42 Berlin and the 42 methodology work with this new tech future? Well, we are creating the Jedi of coders who are going to code it. Hey, would you like to be part of the fun? Come to our website, apply, play the game, and join one of our PCNs. It's going to be absolutely worth it. And beware, you might just fall in love with code. If you'd like to organize an event with us, collaborate, drop us a message, we are always up for it. But most importantly, click on this bell button, subscribe, drop a comment, and tell us how much you love to code. See you.